ونستعينه ونستهديه نعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا من يهدي الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له هاد اشهد ان لا اله الا الله واشهد ان محمدا رسول الله اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى اله وصحبه اجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي امري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقهوا قولي. Today, inshallah, we're going to continue our program, The Doubts of Al-Islam. Again, we are just answering these doubts. We are explaining, actually, these lies, which يعني, some people, they say it. And يعني, they say it in the way it's like looks like against Al-Islam and Al-Muslimin. So we just explain with wisdom, with talk, not with fight, just with talk. Come and talk. This is, inshallah, our system, bidnillahi ta'ala. The hadith that narrated in al-Bukhari wa Muslim, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أُوصِيكُم بِالنِّسَاءِ خَيْرًا فَإِنَّهُنَّ خُلِقْنَا مِنْ ضِلْعٍ أَعْوَجْ وَإِنَّ أَشَدَّ عُوِجَاجَهُ أَعْلَاهُ فَإِنْ أَنْتَ جِئْتَ أَقَمْتَهُ كَسَرْتَهُ وَإِنْ تَرَكْتَهُ لَمْ يَزَلْ أَعْوَجَهُ. What that means, hadith عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, narrated by Imam Muslim and al-Bukhari, sorry, narrated by Abu Hurayrah, collected by Imam al-Bukhari wa Muslim, that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is giving us example that the woman like crooked rib. If you try to strain it, you will break it. If you leave it, will still crooked. But now, the people those who attack this hadith, they said that this hadith is insulting the woman. Why Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is describing the woman like crooked rib? Why? This is the shubha, the doubt. The answer of this, I wanted to know what is the definition of insulting. What is the definition of insulting? If the woman, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created it from the rib of the man, like there is many hadith said that. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the man himself from the earth, from the sand, from the clue. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the human beings, the men themselves. Who is better, sand or rib? Who will decide these definitions? This is the first thing. Yeah, but what is the definition of insulting? This is the first one. The second thing, in the beginning of al-hadith, أُوصِيكُم بِالنِّسَاءِ خَيْرًا. I'm advising you, you have to act kindly with women. This is the beginning of the hadith. And the last of hadith, the end of hadith, it's talking about also kind way. You have to act with your wife, with the woman, kindly. This is the beginning of the hadith, and this is the last of hadith. They just left the beginning and the left and the last thing, and they took in the middle, and they don't understand what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala telling Rasulullah to let Rasulullah tell us. Now, our hearts. Who is protecting our hearts? Question. The ribs, yeah? It's crooked too. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created it in a way to protect your heart. If these ribs are straight, will not be, subhanAllah, يعني, beneficial for your heart. Will not protect your heart. Allah created it in this way. In the same thing. And you wanted to act with women like man, like men, will not match. If you are in this straight and like this, will not match. We have, as a man, to be like this, and the woman to be like this, to attach. We have to be this. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created them like this way. But the core meaning of hadith, advising us to act with them kindly. This is the core meaning. This is the main thing in the hadith. Okay? فسبحانallah, Allah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam here is telling us that don't let the woman treat you like you. Like men, will not match. They have different mentalities. But there is no insulting here. What is the insulting here? I don't know. Rasulullah himself said in another hadith, رِفْقًا بِالْقَوَارِيرِ. He is giving us another example that women like glasses. Just رِفْقًا. Be nice with them. Be gentle with them. Allahu Akbar. Yeah, it's like glasses. If you just treat them bad, you will break them. And same thing. In anta, if you straighten this crooked rib, you will break it. In the hadith, Rasulullah said this. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us, وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ لَكُم مِّنْ أَنفُسِكُمْ أَزْوَاجًا لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. وَالَّذِي خَلَقَ لَكُمْ سُبْحَانَهُ. Allah has created from yourself your wives. Why, ya Allah? لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. A second means housing. That after we finish Salat al-Isha, where will you go? Your house? Why? Why? We wanted to just spend the nights in the streets. Why you have to spend it in your house? Why? Because it's house. Yeah, then, oh, house is protecting me from rains, from winds. It's house. Allah here, in this ayah, great ayah in Surah Al-Rum, Allah is giving us example like your wife, your woman, like your house. That's real houses. لِتَسْكُنُوا إِلَيْهَا. Then Allah said, وَجَعَلَ بَيْنَكُمْ مَوَدَّةً وَرَحْمَةً. He put Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the love and the compassion between or within our hearts. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the description of the woman, which Allah said, it's like houses. And Rasulullah said in many ahadith, it's like glasses. Don't break them. This is what Rasulullah said. This is what Al-Quran said. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is our deen. For completely, yani subhanahu wa ta'ala, wrong what they said, that Islam is against women or insulting women. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept our deen. Innahu ala kulli shay'in qadeer. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.